Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelicals proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heavenly Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he leaves his throne on high, born that man no more may die. Born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, 4 weeks ago we began our journey towards Christmas and lit the first candle of hope, or the prophecy candle, the second candle of peace, or the Bethlehem candle, reminded us of our need for a Savior to save us from our sins and give us peace with God. Then we lit the candle of joy to remind us that Christ is a bringer of true and everlasting joy. The fourth candle of love reminded us of how God's perfect love is found in Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus is a true reason for hope, peace, joy, and love in this season and forever. Let us focus today on the gift of the Christ child as we sign ourselves. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. The white symbolizes the purity of Christ. The Christ candle represents the light that the Son brought into the world when he was born a little baby, God in flesh. This candle represents the moment of transition from prophecy to fulfillment. We cannot be Christians without Christ and without love. We need Christ and Christ's love to share the good news of salvation throughout the earth. Christ connects all the Advent candles. Through him, we can have hope, peace, joy, and love. Because of him, we can be a light unto others, showing them the true meaning of Christmas. As we light the Christ candle, celebrating the end of Advent and the arrival of Christ, let us remember how our Savior came as a lowly baby, that the world might be saved through him, and how he will return one day in glory.
I am the light. to the world. I am the bread you must feed to the hungry, the wine that must cheer every heart. Come, follow me, be the light of the nations, leave your nets and come follow me.
Let us prepare our hearts to listen to what God wants to say to us. A reading from the Gospel according to Saint John. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the world became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of our Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. God is with us, in and through him. Jesus is a true light. Light is a symbol of life, knowledge and goodness. It drives out darkness and confusion and replaces them with vision and clarity. Christ is the one and only one perfect, real and true light. This is echoed in John 14:6 by Jesus, claiming to be the way, the truth, and the life. Not all people will choose to accept that light. Some prefer to deliberately stay in the dark. Jesus knows rejection. He was rejected by the very people he came to rescue. Many say that they are Christ's own, yet do not receive him because they will not part with their sins nor have him to reign over them. He knows what it feels like to be unliked, unwanted, and rejected. Jesus always gives to those who accepted him. Christ gives them the right to become children of God. Trusting in the Lord Jesus, who always gives, let us place our petition before him. Our response after every petition shall be, Lord, let your light shine upon us. God, a loving Father, you sent your Son Jesus Christ into this world to counter all the forces of evil, sin, suffering, and death. Help us to overcome evil with force of good and hatred with the power of love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, let your light shine upon us. Help us never to curse the darkness, but to join with you in bringing your light into this world. The light that is your Son, born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem. We pray to the Lord. Lord, let your light shine upon us. Help us to be instruments of your light and love by carrying out one special act of kindness, or by being your special instrument of reconciliation this new year. We pray to the Lord. Lord, let your light shine upon us. May the Christ candle we lit symbolize our desire to bring light into a world of darkness and hope into a world of despair throughout thoughts, words, and action. We pray to the Lord. Lord, let your light shine upon us. In this year of the pandemic, for those in need of employment, consolation, or understanding, for the spiritual and physical needs of the least of our brothers and sisters, may the new year ahead be a ray of hope, peace, love, and joy as they reflect on the presence of the light of Christ. We pray to the Lord. Lord, let your light shine upon us. Concluding prayer. God, a loving Father, from the beginning of creation, you have manifested your love. When the need for a Savior was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. He brings joy, peace, justice, mercy, and love. Loving God, we thank you for your mystery of the Incarnation. Emmanuel, God with us. Help us receive the light of Christ in our hearts and share it generously and joyfully in our families and communities. Bless all who look upon this little baby, Jesus in the manger. Let his manger remind us of his humble birth and raise our thoughts to him, who is God with us and Savior of all, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive a King. Let every heart prepare Him room.
And heaven and nature sing.
Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains,
Repeat the sounding joy.
He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness.
wonders of His love, and wonders of His love, and wonders, wonders of His love.